Good afternoon, everyone. Hawkbacker here from MaddenAcademy.com. It's Saturday. It means we're ripping into some packs today. We're going to get right into it. Not a whole lot going on, not a whole lot of new content. As you can see, there's Game Changer packs this weekend. They're going to come with gold or better badge, 10 gold or elite players, 4 items, and this weekend they've also got a guaranteed draft badge, which goes with the whole draft content that they released earlier in the week. I'm sure you guys have seen it already. If not, you can check it out on their website. not a whole lot else. The new Ultimate Team players got Derek Brooks and Richard Sherman. Derek Brooks is going to be the 24-hour player that we're going for this afternoon. As you can imagine, both of them have crazy, insane stats. They're both going to be awesome additions to anyone's team. So fingers crossed we're able to pull at least a couple of the collectibles to work towards getting them. You may also see us finally complete the all-rookie set today if we're lucky enough to pull an elite badge. I think all we need is an elite badge for the rest of that set. So if we're lucky enough to pull an elite badge, which we should be since these packs have a guaranteed gold or elite badge supposedly, you'll be able to see us complete that set as well for a little bonus. So let's just jump right into it here. We actually have a lot of packs open because we didn't open any of our Legends packs from last release that we were kind enough to get. So we're not going to open those today, but we'll just open the Game Changer packs and maybe a few Legend packs, see how it goes. But we're going to go ahead and start with the topper here. This is a 99 Ultimate Team player, any of the Ultimates, including the ones that were released today. So, you know, fingers crossed for a Sherman or a Vic or one of those really valuable guys. And we get Gene Upshaw. So obviously a great player. As far as ultimate players go, I don't think he's really worth a lot. But still in crazy, crazy good. 97 pass block, 98 impact, 100 run block. Doesn't get much better than that, so we'll probably just throw him on our line and not worry about reselling him because he's probably going to be an upgrade over what we got. His awareness is not super great, and obviously the speed is low. But as long as you're not running a whole lot of schemes that have a pulling guard, you're not going to worry too much about his acceleration or speed. So as a straight blocker, you know, doesn't get much better than him, so not a bad addition to the team. All right, let's jump into some of these packs and see what we can get out of here. Obviously, any of the 20... I think there's only one 24-hour card this weekend, so obviously getting him would be appreciated. Other than that, just lots of golds to work on sets. Brooks, there's the gold badge. There's the draft badge. So those were the guaranteed drops. Danelle, final edition. Let's see what he. Nick Mangold is the final edition this week if anyone needs a center. His stats aren't crazy good, but you know, he's worth getting if you got the coins and really need a center. I think he's going for fairly inexpensive. So not a great pack. We got the two guaranteed drops, and we got one elite. So moving on here. Ooh, Cam Chancellor. Here we go. That's not a bad pull at all. I think he's one of the rare cards to be putting into the strong safety set. So worth a little bit. Oh, there's another Danelle. Seems to happen to us a lot. We pull the elites and get double. When we pull our other ultimate topper, we'll probably get another Gene. Just based on how our luck's been in the past. Keep going here. Fletcher Cox, Ian Foster, there's the badge again. Oh, we got two badges in this set. That's interesting. Not too bad. They've been kind of hush-hush on what the rewards are going to be for the draft set. I know that they're going to have all the top players will be available, and then whenever they're picked, you can add their draft version of that specific player and the team collectible for whatever team drafts him together to get an upgraded version of him, but that's all they've really said, so we're not sure how many badges everything's going to take and all that, so just be holding on to them. We'll be stacking them along with our combine collectibles and hopefully be able to get some amazing out of hoarding all those for a while. So let's try the next set here. More gold. Another Michael Vick, Flacco. At this point, we're mainly just using these golds to work on the position hero sets. Oh, another two badge pack. Wilkerson. Going to. Just, I think he's worth a decent amount of coin, not nothing crazy. So another alright pack. We'd like to see a little more reds out of these packs instead of just a bunch of golds, but the golds are still helpful to work towards our position heroes. And obviously, we're going to be turning a lot of these golds on the auction house if you haven't checked out our guide on how to really make some coin quick on the auction house. Check it out. It's a good way to kind of use all these golds and get something out of them instead of just letting them sit in your inventory and take up space. So again, nothing good. No, not even an elite in this pack. So keep working. Still working for that elite badge. You'd like to get at least one to be able to finish off that all rookie set. I know it says that you're guaranteed a gold or better, but we've just gotten gold so far. Nothing great. Another draft badge. My gosh, I wonder if these are supposed to have a guaranteed two badges. I think we've only had one pack so far that didn't have two badges. We're gonna have lots of badges ready to go when they release the content. Every year, if you really jump on these sets and all the new content right away, you're able to sell the stuff for crazy high prices, and then after a few days, the prices really calm down. So if we're hoarding all these badges now, we'll be able to jump in there right at the beginning, make a lot of good coin, and then go back and rookie. Nice to get an all rookie card. But like I was saying, we'll be able to jump in there early and make some good coin, and then if there's any players we want for the team, we can go back and buy them a few days later, probably make a decent profit. That's really true for pretty much anything in this game. If you get it early and sell it, you can usually make a decent profit and just go back and buy it later. We did that on a Michael Vick, the Ultimate Michael Vick, when first came out. He was going for something like 2 million or something, and now he's down to like 400,000. So if you got him the beginning and sold him for 2 million, go back and buy him now for 400,000. Nice little profit. You just gotta be patient with it. Still no elite badge, still no amazing elite players. It's a golds. Man. Keep working it here. Still looking for a big hit. Oh, there's a JJ Watt. That's a decent pull. He doesn't go into any sets, that's surprising. You know, I mean, when this card first came out, it went for some good coin. Now he's kind of outclassed. Oh, there we go. There's one of those team-specific collectibles I was talking about. We haven't seen any of those yet. Cardinals draft pick. They have a decent pick. They'll probably be able to get a decent player in the first round. That'll hopefully be worth something if we hold on to this and upgrade him. Probably hold on. I think they said they're tradable but not sellable. Yeah, so if we get duplicates we can trade them, but otherwise you're not gonna be putting them on the auction house. So we'll hold on to them. At least we got a card that's got a first round pick. If you get a Seahawks collectible or something like that, you're probably not gonna be looking too good. It's always possible they trade up, but I find it's highly unlikely that they do. So alright, still not a whole lot. One draft badge and a draft collectible. Keep plugging away here. Gold badge. Deerdorf collectible for the Deerdorf set. I think we've already completed that on this one, so we're not going to have another collectible, position collectible to finish it, so we'll throw him on the auction block. Eric Reed Final Edition also goes to the Nick Mangold. It gives us a couple cards towards the Nick Mangold if we really want to finish him off. Most of the time, it's better to sell the collectibles individually than complete the collection and sell the reward if you're trying to just make coin. So we'll have to look at that and see if he's worth getting or if we'll just sell off the collectibles. Not a whole lot in this one. Nice to get an ultimate collectible, although the Deerdorf one isn't great. Obviously, we'd prefer to have one of the newer ones, the Megatron, or one of the ones from today. But Deerdorf, you know, it's good to get one regardless of who it's for. Alright, let's see if we can up our luck here. I think we're due. It's been a couple weeks since we've hit anything big. Still looking for an elite badge too. I really want to finish off that rookie. Man. We didn't need Julius Thomas for the tight end set, but we need the elite. So not a whole lot on these packs. Overall kind of disappointing. But let's actually, we can buy the two extra we have in this one before I switch over. So you'll actually get a little preview of a couple extra. We'll open 24 packs. We got a couple of extra 1,000 points that we were granted, so that was kind of nice. Let's see what we can pull. Maybe we'll get the luck just out of the not using a bundle, just single packs. Change our luck around. Another gold badge. Where are the elite badges at, man? It must just be. There's Vernon Davis for the new combine collectible. This is the actual player himself, so this, I think, as far as the collectibles go, this is worth the least compared to all the specific collectibles. But still good to have. We're trying to complete all of them to get all the combine rewards for whenever they release that final set for all the different combine collectibles. Hopefully turn something out of it. David DeCastro, right guard. I think we actually, I thought we might need him for the position hero, but we already used him. There's our draft badge. So not too bad. Got an elite out of this one at least, and a combine collectible. Maybe it's just staying away from the bundles and getting the single packs is going to be it for upping our luck. Another Coney Ealy. What was I saying about the getting duplicates? We opened two all rookies and they're the same one. Oh man, and there's two draft badges. Another gold badge, man. Cannot get an elite badge. There we go, there's another Vernon Davis. Gives us a little bit of progress towards the set. Real quick. And then we will hop over onto our second account and we'll go ahead and open our other bundle. Let's get one more shot at getting that elite badge or getting a little more, and hopefully we'll be able to hit something.